Really, today's directive from the governor comes as the South African variant of the virus has been discovered in eastern Virginia. And regarding this announcement, Northam says that it is in the best interest of children to do so.
Children learn better in classrooms, and that's where they need to be.
Those words from Virginia Governor Ralph Northam Friday as he calls for all Virginia school systems to offer some form of in-person learning by March 15th.
Is this a mandate? This is a direction from the governor. I obviously oversee our superintendents, our school boards.
Among the reasons why, Northam points to a change in guidance from the federal level, including the CDC, which said it is possible to do so safely with precautions, even without vaccinating school staff first.
But we've seen more data now, and it suggests that schools don't have the kind of rapid spread that we've seen in some other congregate settings.
Among those who spoke in favor of the shift,
our students need in-person instruction.
Virginia's Teacher of the Year, Anthony Swan, who says when his students were on virtual days during a hybrid model, they wouldn't do the work.
Once they returned to school, I had to play catch-up with them instead of being able to move forward with instruction and curriculum.
However, the Virginia Education Association said that while no one wants back in the school more than teachers, setting an arbitrary date was not the best way to do so. Along with a focus on safety measures, they called for a continued focus on vaccinating educators. On that front, Northam says he's confident if Virginia's vaccination pace continues, a majority of teachers will soon have access to it.
If not by March 15th, shortly thereafter.
And along with a return to in-person learning, officials also asked districts for more summer school options to catch students up and say they are working on guidance.
Now, regarding that March 15th deadline, it is at odds with two local school districts, Petersburg, which is planning to stay virtual till April, and Richmond for the remainder of the school year. We have heard from two school board members in Richmond, one for, one against today's announcement, while Superintendent Jason Camera said in an email that he is still processing the details and will have more to say next week.